Hello everyone, welcome back to this series of Android application development. Now today in this video I am going to show you how a radio button actually works. Now you might have seen the radio buttons while filling some online application forms, in which when you have to choose your gender, either male or female. So to begin with, firstly I am changing this constraint layout to linear layout, setting its orientation to vertical, and I'm removing this text view. Now over here we need a radio group first. Radio group, set its width and height to wrap content, and inside this radio group we need our radio buttons. Now the question arises, why do we need this radio group? If we declare the radio button outside the radio group, or if we do not declare our radio group, what happens is we can select multiple options like a checkbox. It will behave just similar to as the checkbox work, but in the radio button, out of all, only one should be selected. So if we initialize all our radio buttons inside the radio group, if I am initializing three buttons, then out of three only one is selected at a time. No multiple selection will be done inside the radio group. So we are declaring only over here we will declare only two radio buttons inside the radio group. Now I am giving it text to male and text size to 50 and giving it ID as male. Now another radio button, text to female, text size to be 50 SP and ID female. Now this is our design. When I will check the male button, the female will be unchecked, and if I check the female button, the male will be unchecked, and the toast message will be generated. Now moving to this coding part. Now we will initialize it a radio group RG, but here we haven't initialized the ID of the radio group, so here we need a ID, radio group ID. Okay, so over here now we have to identify. So RG is equals to find view by ID R dot ID dot radio group ID. Now radio group dot set on check chain listener new radio group dot on check chain listener. Now over here you can see that ID checked ID. Now here we have to pass the ID of the buttons. Over here we have made two IDs, for one for male and one for female. So what we have to do, we can use switch case over here also, or you can use if else. In the radio buttons I have already shown you the if else method. Over here I will show you the switch case method. So in the switch, pass this ID, and inside the switch we have to make a case. And in the case we will be using the ID, so r dot id dot male colon. Now inside this we have to generate a toast message that shows male. A pop-up will come up that male is written. It's compulsory to add a break statement also, otherwise it will jump to the next case. Now next case, r dot id dot female. Now inside this again we have to generate a toast message displaying female, and we have to add a break keyword also. Now our coding is completed. Now let's run this app and check it out. Now our app is installing. Now this is our app. Now when I click on the mail, a pop-up text message should generate. Yes, it is generating mail. Now when I should click on the female, the mail should be unchecked. Yes, it's happening. It's just because of radio group. If we don't declare these buttons, these radio buttons inside the radio group, then we could select both at a time. It will just behave like a checkbox. So it's compulsory to declare both the radio group, both the radio buttons inside a radio group. Okay, thank you so much for watching this video.